A woman accused of killing her husband in an attempt murder suicide with their pet parrot as the only witness.
Vienna Durham, age 46, is charged with first degree murder for allegedly shooting her husband, Martin, aged 45, on 12th May 2015, and then turning the gun on herself in the Navego County's Ensley Township home in Michigan. She survived. The alleged murder-suicide has drawn attention from its unusual witness, the couple's pet parrot. Weeks after his death, Martin Durham's family recorded the bird parroting what they believed to be the victim's last words, "Don't fucking shoot," but could be heard on a video that family members recorded several weeks after killing and in which they insisted he was mimicking the couple as they were arguing. The prosecutor says he hasn't ruled out putting the African grey parrot bird on the stand. At the preliminary hearing on Friday to decide the case goes to trial, a neighbor, Connie Ream, testified how she was the first one to find the couple. She said she heard two gunshots in the morning and thought that Martin might be hunting, but that it was too early. The next day, she went to check on her neighbors and found them on the floor in the bedroom, with neither one moving. Martin had been shot 5 times. Glenna would spend months in the hospital recovering from a gunshot wound to the head. Martin's mother, Lillian Durham, insists the parrot, Bud, recounts what sounds like an argument, changing voices from male to female. "That bird picks up everything and anything, and it's got the filthiest mouth around," she said. "I personally think he was there, and he remembers it, and he was saying it," said Martin's father, Charles. After the shooting, Glenna told police she did not remember the day leading up to what happened, but stressed that she did not kill her husband. However, police documents show that Glenna was considered a suspect in the case and that she had left 3 suicide notes in the house, one to her ex-husband and one to each of her children. One of the notes read, "I'm sorry, but I love you and so sorry I have been a disappointment to you these last 12 years or so. Please forgive me, you're one of the best things I ever did. Love, Mom." Glenna also denied to investigators that she had written the suicide notes, but a handwriting analysis showed she did, said police. The police records further detailed the couple's financial problems, gambling issues, and a potentially troubled marriage. One document from 2010 showed Glenna gambled nearly $75,000 on slots, more than twice what Marty gambled that same year. Family said the couple had been married more than 10 years and had been living in their Sand Lake home for more than 15 years. The two always kept their doors locked and none of the family had keys to the home, according to documents. They said that Martin found out about a month before his death that their home was going into foreclosure due to outstanding debts.